children, now in this class we are going to study about the general characteristic feature of the class, that is A's. A's are also known as birds. Okay, birds are very active animals in this world, isn't it? So these are very active organisms. So these birds habitat, so they adapt with flying mode of locomotion, and habitat they are the aerial. Okay, these organisms are aerial in their habitat and they rest on the trees. Okay, they adapted aerial mode of habitat, they adopted aerial habitat. Okay, and the most unique characteristic feature of these organisms are presence of feathers. Presence of feathers. Feathers is the characteristic feature. Of birds. Body is covered with, it is fully covered with feathers. Okay. Body is dry. Body is dry. Okay. It does not contain any secreting glands on their body or on their skin. But only one oil gland is present. Oil gland. Is formed only under the tail. Okay, only under the tail. Tail means, that means at the posterior region. Okay, at the posterior region they have an oil gland. At the posterior region they have oil gland under their tail. Okay, and under the feathers you may call them. Okay, and oil gland is at the base of their tail. Okay, and then under the tail. Okay, and fourth characteristic feature is they have wings. Here they have two pairs of limbs where four limbs are modified. Four limbs are modified into wings. Okay. Four limbs are modified into wings for flight. For flight. Okay. And fifth characteristic feature is, so they have well developed organ systems. Okay. And these organisms, the body, it is, body is boat shaped. Body is boat shaped. Okay. And exoskeleton, body is boat shaped, which helps for, flight. Okay. In A. Exoskeleton is bony. That means exoskeleton is made up of bones, and these bones are special type of bones, that is air-filled bones. Air-filled bones. They are called as hollow bones. Air-filled bones called pneumatic bones. Pneumatic bones. Okay, these are air-filled bones, and makes, so this presence of this pneumatic bones makes them, they are very less in their weight. Okay, so presence of air-filled bones called pneumatic bones. This also one of the major characteristic feature you can see in case of the A's or the words. Okay, heart is four chamber. Heart is four chamber. So that is two auricles and two ventricles. Two auricles and two ventricles. Okay, and complete double circulation takes place in these organisms. Okay. And complete double circulation takes place. Alimentary canal, ear. Alimentary canal contain two extra chambers here. Two extra chambers here. Okay, so those are called extra chambers. Crop and gizzard. Crop and gizzard. So these two are the extra chambers found in the alimentary canal of these apes. Okay. And respiration is through well developed lungs. Respiration takes place through lungs. Respiration takes place lungs. Okay, and these are uricotelic organisms. Uricotelic organisms. That means uric acid is their nitrogenous base. They excrete uric acid as their nitrogenous base. The very concentrated nitrogenous base they are going to excrete. So that's why these are called as uricotelic organisms. Okay, and these are oviparous. These are oviparous, and eggs are covered with calcareous shell, hard calcareous shell. Hard calcareous shell. So that's why these are called as cladoid eggs. These are known as cladoid eggs. Reptiles also, they lay eggs, and their eggs also covered by calcareous shell. So the eggs which are covered with calcareous shell, hard shells, those are called as cladoid eggs. So these birds, they are also laying the cladoid eggs. That means eggs are covered with calcareous shell. Okay. Very important, these are homeothermic animals. Very, very important. Okay. Fishes, amphibians, reptiles. So these are poikilotherms. Okay. And apes and mammals, these are homeothermic animals. These are homeotherms. Homeotherms means warm-blooded animals. Homeotherms means warm-blooded. That means they maintain constant body temperature. Okay, they are going to maintain constant body temperature. Constant body temperature. They maintain constant body temperature. So such organisms are called as homeotherms. Okay. And next, sexes are separate. Sexes are separate. Oviparous. Fertilization is internal. Fertilization is internal. Fertilization takes place in these organisms. Okay, and development is external. Fertilization is internal. Development is external. Both in case of that amphibians, reptiles, and birds. Fertilization here in reptiles and birds it is internal. Development is external. Okay. Development is external. Okay. And see, fly. example for the flightless bird, ostrich. Okay, ostrich is a bird, but it is flightless bird. Ostrich is flightless bird. Flightless bird. See, these are some of the, and also another characteristic feature, main characteristic feature is there, that is here in this edge. Here the jaws are replaced by, or jaws are modified by, very important here. Jaws are modified into toothless beak. Toothless beak. Okay? Toothless beak. The birds have toothless beak and jaws are modified into toothless beak. Okay? And these limbs. Okay? So, four limbs they are modified for flight. Okay? That means they modified into wings. So, those are helpful for their flight. And the hind limbs are there, no? Hind limbs. Hind limbs used for. Hind limbs used for different purposes. So, for climbing purpose, for clasping. Okay. Climbing. Clasping. Clasping is to hold the branches of the tree. Okay. So, for that purpose, these are used. Okay. See, these are some of the characteristic features we can see in case of aves. Okay. And examples for these. Examples. See, here also development is external and direct development. Okay. There is no any larval stage. Okay. Corvus. Examples. Corvus, that is pro for that example. And then Columba. Columba, that is pigeon. Okay. And Pavo, peacock. Okay. And then vertebrates. Okay, so that is mammalia. Mammalia. So mammalia, they are found everywhere. The main characteristic feature of or unique feature of mammalia is the presence of the mammary glands. Okay, presence of mammary gland is the characteristic feature of presence of mammary glands is the characteristic feature of mammalia. Okay, and this presence of mammary glands, they are helpful for nourishing their young ones. After the delivery, the young ones, they are nourished, okay, nurtured by the mammary glands. They secrete milk, okay, so that is helpful for the nourishment of the young ones. And one more unique feature is presence of hairs on skin. Presence of hairs on skin. It is also one of the unique feature found in mammalians. Okay, and habitat where they are living. See, they are adapted different modes of habitat, different types of habitat they have. They are found in caves, okay, and there are some of them are arboreal, that means they are living on trees, and some are burrowing animals are there. They are living under the under the soil. So like this, different habitats they are adapted, different types of habitat they are adapted. So they are living in polar ice caps. Different, they live in different habitats. Different habitats they have adapted. They are adapted. Polar ice caps, some of them polar bears, polar ice caps. Polar ice caps, they live in caves. Okay, and they live on trees and they live in burrows. Okay, they live in burrows. Okay, forests, grasslands, forests, and they live in grasslands. Okay, like this, they are adapted different type of habitat they have adapted, and most of them. So there are some of them that live in water also, and some they are also they adapted the flying mode of habitat. And fourth general characteristic feature is they have two pairs of limbs that is used for different purposes. Two pair of limbs they have. Two pair of limbs they have, and they are adapted for running, climbing, adapted for walking, running, climbing, okay, and also for different purposes. So climbing, and so for swimming, burrowing, flying, swimming, burrowing, flying. Okay, see, the limbs are used for different purposes. Okay, and external ear or pinna is found in these organisms. External ear or pinna are present. Okay, in those organisms, in amphibians and reptiles, so ear, it tympanum represents the external ear, but in this case, external ear, they are well developed. That means ear pinna, they are formed. Okay, and they have thecodont. Okay, they have thecodont and heterodont. Heterodont and diphyodont. Diphyodont. So the presence of ecodon, heterodon and dicot, they have or presence of. See, they have teeth, okay, and ecodon means the teeth are located in a well-defined jaws. Okay, so these are located inside the well-defined jaws. Okay, and heterodont means different types of teeth are found. Different types of teeth are found in these organisms. And diphyodont means they have two sets of teeth. Two sets of teeth they have. Okay, see, presence of ecodont, heterodont and diphyodont is the characteristic feature of the mammals. Okay, and then these are homeotherms. These are homeotherms. Homeotherms means these are warm-blooded animals. Okay, and then respiration is through lungs. Respiration is through lungs, and alimentary canal ends with anus. Alimentary canal ends with anus. Anus is the opening of digestive system. Okay, and excretion takes place through the kidneys. Excretory organs are the kidneys. Excretory organs are the kidneys. Okay, and these are ureotelic organism. That means their nitrogenous base are the urea. Okay, and reproduction, sexes are separate, reproduction, sexual reproduction, and fertilization is internal, development is also internal and direct development. Sexes are separate, gametosexual dimorphism. Fertilization is internal, development is direct, that is also internal. Development is internal. These are viviparous organisms. These are viviparous organisms. That means they are giving rise to young ones directly. They are not the egg-laying organisms. They are viviparous, means they directly give birth to young ones, except platypus and echidna. Except platypus and echidna. Okay. Except platypus and the echidna. So these are the egg-laying mammals. Platypus and echidna, these are oviparous egg-laying mammals. So except these two, all are viviparous organisms. Okay. So let us study about the examples for these mammals. So characteristic feature, so heart is also four chambered here. Okay, fully double circulation takes place here. Okay, examples, examples: Macropus, that is kangaroo. Okay, and Pteropus, flying fox. Pteropus and Camelus, camel. ओके एंड देन मैं क्या आता हूँ मुर्गी
biological classification and also for the animal kingdom. Okay, thank you.